This is a really nice book, even though I didn't write it. It's Introduction to Counting and Probability by David Patrick. Really nice book. Has a lot of counting and probability techniques, and you can get your own copy. I think there's a link. It's right down there. Right up. I can't quite see over the edge, but you can see it. Get your own copy. In fact, that's what we're going to do in this lesson. We're going to find the probability that you get your own copy of this book right after this lesson. Now, I realize the probability isn't the same for everybody. They'll be going out and grabbing this book right after this lesson because, you know, some of you really like the lessons, and, well, I guess some of you don't. And the people who like the lessons are probably a little more likely to go out and get their very own copy of this very nice book. So to find the probability that you're going to get this book, right after this lesson, well, we're going to have to consider two different cases. First, we're going to have to think about what happens if you like these lessons, and second, what happens if you don't. We'll look at case one first. And the case one is you really like these lessons. I'll go ahead and write that down. You really like these lessons. You know, you think the instructor is witty, he's funny, maybe he's a little weird, but you like the lessons anyway. And it's about 3/4 likely that you like the lessons. So the probability that case one, you like the lessons, 3/4. Now, the probability that you buy this book, if you like the lessons, is 9/10. So we say buy book. In case one, the probability is 9/10. You might wonder, well, why isn't it one? I mean, everybody that likes these lessons should get these books. Well, I realize some of you already have the book. So about 1/10 of you probably already have the book, so you're not going to run out and get it. But you know, it is a nice book. You know, maybe you have friends, brother, sister. Maybe even mom and dad could learn a little counting and probability. So wouldn't be the worst thing in the world to get another one. So case one, 3/4 of the time you like the lessons. And if you like the lessons, probability you're going to buy the book right after this lesson, links right down there, is 9/10. But then there's case two. Now, I'm not too fond of case two. Don't really like to talk about it very much, but that's when you don't like the lessons. You know, maybe you think the instructor, you know, maybe you think he runs on at the mouth a little too much, talks about his books too much, and you don't like the lessons. Now, you either like him or you don't, so if it's 3/4 likely that you like the lessons, it's 1/4 likely that you don't like them. And I have to wonder about your taste in lessons, but if you don't like the lessons, the probability that you're going to buy this book right here, fortunately for us, it's still pretty high. Probability that you're going to buy this book right after this lesson, that probability is 4/5. And we wondered why this was the case, but then I thought, well, maybe people are getting this book, it's a really nice book, because they figure, hey, that instructor guy didn't quite follow what he was trying to explain, so maybe the book will explain it a little bit better. I'm not so sure how I feel about that explanation, but it's awfully nice of you guys to buy the books. So now we need to find the total probability. The total probability that you're going to buy the book. Now we have two separate exclusive cases. And just like when we're doing casework counting, when we're doing casework probabilities, to get our total probability, take these two cases, they don't overlap, and every single person either likes lessons or doesn't like the lessons, so they fall in one of these cases, and we add these probabilities together. So our total probability is going to be the probability of case one plus the probability of case two. So our case one is you like the lessons and you buy the book. So 3/4 of the time, you like the lessons. And of that 3/4 of the time, you're going to buy the book 9/10 of the time. So the probability that you like the lessons and you're going to buy the book 3/4 times 9/10. In the same way, case two, you don't like the lessons 1/4 of the time. And of that 1/4 of the time, you buy the book anyway 4/5 at a time. So the probability that you don't like the lessons, but you buy the book anyways, 1/4 times 4/5. And now the rest is just arithmetic. So 3/4 times 9/10, that's 27/40. plus 1/4 times 4/5, that's just 1/5. We get a common denominator. This is 35 over 40. And we can reduce that to 7/8. 7/8, that's pretty high. You have a 7/8 probability that right after this lesson ends, you're going to buy this book. 7/8 is pretty high. We may as well just round that up to 1. You can click that link. It's right down there.